Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Why am I kidding? There are no ladies, so gents, welcome back. So I could not do much on the RXZ because I was busy with work and plus it needed some spares. So there is a big bag full of spares which I'll show you guys in a minute. But this is the first video after we bought this guy, so I hope you can hear me loud and clear. So not only the mic, I'm actually also talking little loud, so excuse me if I become too loud. So let's see what all things I actually bought for the RXZ. So I'll show you guys those things, and hopefully, let's see if we have time, then we'll start the assembly as well. So the spares that you see in this small plastic thing is actually worth 2000 rupees. So it's a small stack, but this thing is worth 2000 rupees. This is one bolt that couple of my subscribers said is really difficult to get. This is the engine foundation bolt, the one which goes in the bottom. But guess what? I got two of these. So one will go into storage and one will go on the RXZ. And I actually had a switch, but I actually bought a brand new switch because yeah, I had to go stingy on this. Then I got accelerator cable and clutch cable. This bike's ignition coil I had fixed on the RX100, so I bought the ignition coil as well. Then I got a brand new pin for the stand. I might get the stand later. I mean, not the stand, I'm saying the brake pedal. Then I got bulbs, washers, some miscellaneous rubber stuff. So yeah, I'll show you guys. I actually rebuilt the wiring loom. So this is a brand new wiring loom that I actually bought from Yamaha. This is the latest Yamaha RX-135 wiring. So the difference between this wiring and the RXZ wiring is one, this connector mainly. So this connector I had to run, oops, some extra wires for that. So that is why you see the loom looks a little ugly. So I have bought some stuff, like I have bought the insulation tape, which I was running low on. So I'll go ahead and wrap the whole thing in insulation tape. I got some bushes as well. So yeah, in the next 1 hour I can start and complete everything. So I'll start with the wiring and we'll do a detailed wiring video, hopefully. So stay tuned. So the whole program got interrupted by this as well as this guy. So they are running around and playing. It's almost 10 o'clock. So let's hope I'm able to work on this, because like you can see, the first thing she has attacked is the tripod. So if I'm not able to complete the wiring today, then you know, I know who's responsible for it. So yeah, the wiring has been snaked through the headlight dome. What I've done is I moved the wiring loom through the hole in the bottom, and there is a hole in the middle. So through that hole, I have actually planned to snake all the wires which come from the top. Okay, so I'll show you guys that. So there is that 5-pin connector I was talking about. I have connected that to the tailpiece. Now next thing to connect is the battery, so which I'm going to do. So there is a fuse thing that comes here, so I have to check if I have that fuse thing. Another sad part is the handle yoke I actually forgot to buy. And so she is pretty disruptive at this age, so I'm not able to focus at my work, and you know, take care of her. So if I don't take care of her, then there is a very good chance that she might end up crying and by doing some stupid stuff, and then I'll be in a lot of trouble. So you will see some interruptions like this in between. So what we'll do is we'll take the fuse thing from the RX100, because we have borrowed the battery also from here, so it's just a temporary thing, so we will hopefully return it once. So yeah, let me remove this and I'll put it down. Okay, though we are going to install an RDD CDI into this bike, but what I'm going to do is, for the sake of wiring, I'll show you guys how you connect the CDI, because there might be some folks who would be interested in rewiring the whole bike. So for them, the other installation of the other CDI won't make sense. So what I've done is I've connected the ground end, the positive, to the battery. So now there is supply, and then this goes here with two screws. So you put two screws here, and then all you need to do is just match the colors. One big problem about powder coating is all these bolt threads get covered with the powder coating material, and then they get baked, so it is like there is no thread, so it is really difficult to run it. I had a helicoil set, but I forgot where it is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just wire tie it, maybe in this hole, so that is perfect. So I got connected the ground of the wiring loom to the ignition coil. Ignition coil is just simple, two screws, just remove it, this whole thing slides out. So I was thinking probably I'll do it in detail, but that really doesn't warrant much of a detail. So this has a orange wire that connects to the orange female in the loom. So let me see if I can give you a better view. So this is the orange female in the loom. So that connects to the orange male from the ignition coil. So again, I wish I had three hands. So that is not easy to do it with one hand. Okay, so yeah, it's in. Next is the flasher relay. So there is a connector, 2-pin connector, that goes into the flasher relay, and the flasher relay kind of, if you buy the original one, it clips into place. Then you have the RR unit, also called the regulator rectifier unit. So for an RX, you can use Crux Libro and Gladiator RR unit or RX 135. If you still get original, don't buy Swiss ones, those are crap. So this is an original one that I had in my stock. So yeah, install that. Then this is the wire that comes from the coil. So if you look at the wiring loom, there are a couple of connectors that needs to go here. So let me just pull this out here. These two wires are for the brake switch, so I'm going to leave it down. So there is a 4-pin connector that connects to this plug. So this is how the main supply comes. So 4 wires, blue, yellow stripe wire, white and black. So that goes into a connector with similar colors. So just thread it through here. Again, just match the lock. So just no drama, slides in. Then you have the CDI. The CDI has 3 individual wires and a 2-pin connector. So the 2-pin connector goes into this 2-pin slot in the wiring loom. It locks in. Then all you need to do is just match the wire colors. So there is this black and white female that connects to the black and white male in the wiring loom. So it is just matching colors. It's really difficult for me to do it with one hand, and then this kind of screws in here like this, so it comes from under. So yeah, you need to connect those. Then in an RxZ there is one more connector which is not there in the 135, which is the oil warning switch. So this is the extra wiring that I had to build, because this was a RX 135 wiring loom, and getting an RxZ 5-speed wiring loom is not easy. So you can get 4-speed, but I didn't want to do major surgery on that, so that's why I got the original RX 135 5-speed wiring, and then I connected these. So I'm actually fighting this really, and it is not going in. So let me just, so yeah, that is connected now. Let's move into the dome. So I'm not sure if you guys can see all the wires, because it is pretty dark here. Okay, so if you have an RX 135 5-speed, you will have a female connector like this. In the wiring loom, if it is 4-speed, then this would be a male connector, and this connector would be on the wiring loom. So since this is the new wiring with a pass switch, so we have this kind of a connector. So first thing that I would do is I will connect this. So that is done. Then the second thing is, there is the ignition switch which goes into this black connector. So I'll connect that as well. So yeah, that is connected. This 6-pin connector is for the pilot lamp socket, which of course I need to search. This connector is basically for the kill switch. I have to change that. This is not the connector that I'm going to use, and this is for the tachometer light. It has both. This is the parking light, and this one is from the oil level indicator. So from this connector I'll have to connect a male connector like this, I mean a female connector like this, and then from there probably I need to connect 2 bulbs. So yeah, almost all the connections are done. Just the 6-pin connector for the pilot lamp is not, so let me go ahead and fix the pilot lamp, fix it here, and then I'll connect it, and then let's check if all the lights are working. By the way, the indicator should be working now, hopefully. Yeah, so as you can see, I have wired the rear indicator, that is working. So let me check the other one. For some reason the other one is not, so we'll have to check why it is not working. So that we will do later. Let me connect the front indicator also to the So there comes a spanner in the build. I have misplaced the 6-pin connector, pilot lamp wiring harness somewhere. It is somewhere in that pile, which I'm hoping to unravel maybe during the weekend. So it is not where I usually keep my stuff. I usually keep all my stuff in this box, so I could not find it here somewhere. I'm thinking that it should be under there, or else if nothing works out, I cut a connector from this loom and create a new connector altogether, which is also a possibility. But first we'll try to look for the other thing, and then hopefully if we find it, then good, great, awesome. If we don't, then we'll have to build a new one. So also things like the chain are inside that pile. So since the flooring work was supposed to commence, I did everything in a haste, and now I'm kind of repenting that. So yeah, let me just put everything back. Almost like I wired the indicators and stuff. The only thing remaining now is actually the pilot lamp. It would have been nice if we had that, and plus to wire the working light, probably do it through the battery. So let's see. So not much left to connect. So this is almost most of the wiring that you will see. There is one connector that goes